This section examines fuel lift pumps for diesel engines. The lift pump transfers fuel from the tank to the fuel injection system. In modern vehicles, the tank is mounted below the engine, and the fuel has to be lifted up to the level of the engine. Three types of lift pump are common on light vehicle diesel engines: the diaphragm type pump, the plunger pump, and the vane pump. The diaphragm type pump can be mounted on the engine or on the injection pump. It is fitted with inlet and outlet valves, and an eccentric on a camshaft acts on a two-piece rocker arm connected to a diaphragm. Rotating the eccentric causes the rocker arm to pivot on its pin and pull the diaphragm down. This compresses the diaphragm return spring and increases the volume in the pumping chamber above the diaphragm. Atmospheric pressure at the fuel tank forces fuel along the fuel line to open the inlet valve. Fuel flows into the pumping chamber. The eccentric keeps rotating and the rocker arm is released. The spring exerts force on the diaphragm to pressurize the fuel in the chamber. This pressure closes the inlet valve and opens the outlet valve, letting fuel be delivered to the injection system. If the system doesn't need all of the fuel delivered, the pressure in the outlet fuel line rises to the same level as in the pumping chamber. That holds down the diaphragm and keeps the diaphragm return spring compressed. When this occurs, the split linkage in the rocker arm allows the lever to maintain contact with the eccentric without acting on the diaphragm pull rod. A second type of lift pump in light vehicle applications is the plunger pump. It's mounted on the inline injection pump and it's driven by a cam inside the inline injection pump housing. Internally, a spring-loaded cam follower converts the rotary motion of the camshaft into reciprocating motion. The reciprocating All diesel engines in light vehicle applications have a priming lever on the lift pump or a separate priming pump to allow for removing air from the fuel system. This is called bleeding or priming. Air can enter the system during filter replacement or when a fuel line is disconnected. Without a priming facility, the start motor would have to crank the engine over to bleed and prime the system. Excessive use of the starter motor for this purpose would damage it and it would soon discharge the battery. This diaphragm lift pump has a lever that acts on the diaphragm rocker arm. Moving the priming lever moves the diaphragm down. Releasing the lever allows the diaphragm return spring to force the diaphragm up. The action of the diaphragm and valves during bleeding is the same for normal operation of the pump. Since distributor type injection pumps use an internal vane pump, their fuel supply system incorporates a diaphragm type priming pump, usually located on top of the fuel filter. This filter housing includes a diaphragm type priming pump. The diaphragm is connected to an actuating button, and it's held in its uppermost position by a diaphragm spring. Reed valves connect the priming pump housing to the filter. Pressing down on the actuating button reduces the volume in the pumping chamber, which forces fuel into the filter element. Releasing the button lets the spring lift the diaphragm, which increases the volume in the pumping chamber. Air pressure in the fuel tank then forces fuel into the pumping chamber. A plunger-type priming pump is often used with plunger lift pumps that are mounted on inline injector pumps. It can also be mounted on top of fuel filter housings for distributor-type injector pump systems. The plunger-type priming pump consists of a plunger and a barrel assembly mounted on the side of the plunger pump or on a filter housing. This plunger priming pump uses the valves of the plunger lift pump to direct fuel flow. Plunger pumps mounted on the top of filter housings contain inlet and outlet check valves. Pulling the primer plunger increases chamber volume, which decreases the pressure in the chamber below that of atmospheric. Fuel in the tank is forced along the fuel lines, through the inlet check valve, and into the pumping chamber. Pushing the plunger into the barrel decreases the volume in the chamber, which forces fuel out through the outlet check valve. When the priming pump is not in use, the hand knob must be screwed closed. This stops fuel leaking out past the plunger and also stops air leaking into the priming plunger barrel.